How do I find downloads on my PC? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. When I download files like ebooks off the internet, I can never find them. Where do they go on my computer? Well, kind of depends on how you downloaded them. But what I want to do in this video is basically show you what the different approaches are. If we take a look here in my browser, you can see I'm actually looking at the companion article for this video. How do I find downloads on my PC? Askleo.com/downloads will get you there. And down on this page, I have an example file to download. Note that this is Edge that we're using right now. That will become important as we go forward. Now, if I just click on this link, it brings up the PDF. What it did is it downloaded it to essentially a temporary location for that file and then immediately started showing it to me. Now, the link I showed you is a full URL. Very often you'll see something that actually obfuscates the actual URL with kind of a click here link or a button or something like that. But the net result is the same. If I were to click on the click here to download, it brings up this PDF in my browser. Now, if we go back to that and bring up, again, that PDF in the browser, you can, if you want to, save it from here without necessarily downloading it again. You can see that there's a save button. And if you click on that save button, you can then basically save the file to a location of your own choosing. If I do that, boom, the file has been downloaded. And it's been placed where I told it to be placed. That's one approach. However, you don't have to go through this two-step approach. If we go back to the page that had the links, you can instead right-click on the link and choose Save Link As. Once again, I could save it in any location of my choice. In this case, the browser will not show you the file. It'll download it directly to wherever you indicated. In this case, I've been using PDFs for my examples. And the reason that they kind of obfuscate things is that Edge in particular is trying really hard to be your PDF reader. If it's not a PDF, in other words, if it's a .zip file or something like that, then Edge isn't going to try and open it up. Instead, it's going to download it. And it's going to download it in one of two places: the default save location or the last place you downloaded something. That is a choice you can make. So from the start, if you've never downloaded anything before and you now download this zip file, it will go to your system's default download location, which is usually the download folder you'll find in Windows File Explorer. If, on the other hand, you choose to save that file somewhere else, then the browser may default to that somewhere else the next time you download anything. So you do have to pay attention to where the browser is downloading things, particularly when you say save as. Again, this is one of those things that may be different from browser to browser. That's why I point out that I'm using Edge. Chrome may be different. Firefox may be different. The default behaviors might be different. But in all cases, they have a way for you to say either just download and have it go to whatever it thinks is the correct download location, or you can right-click on the link and save link as or save file as or whatever. Now, it is possible in most browsers, there's a setting that you can have the browser always ask you what to do with a download. So if I go here to settings in Edge, and I click on downloads here on the left-hand side, you can see that the default location is, in fact, the downloads folder for my sign-in account. This is the downloads folder that shows up in Windows File Explorer. But I also have it set to ask me what to do with each download. That way, Clicking on a download link will never just download the file somewhere. It'll ask you, where would you like the file? And you can then choose your download folder, some other folder, depending on whatever it is you're doing. I also tend to not have open Office files in browser. Much like PDF, Office files can sometimes be displayed within the browser without actually downloading the file. 99 times out of 100, if I've got a link to an Office file, it's because I want to download it. So we'll turn that one off as well. But now when I click on a download link, it should ask me where I want to put that download. Now, if you're still confused, if there are so many different possibilities for where downloads can go, there's one more place for you to use, and I believe this is very common across all the browsers. While looking at your browser, type Ctrl-J. This will give you the list of files that you have downloaded recently. In my case, yes, I've got some other ones that I downloaded previously. The point here, though, is that there are interesting icons associated with each file. Open file means exactly that. It's exactly like double-clicking on the file if you were looking at it in Windows File Explorer. There's a folder icon that will allow you to open Windows File Explorer on whatever folder that file got downloaded to. That might be the most useful thing for you if you're wondering where the file went. So if I click on this, it opens Windows File Explorer, shows me where that file got downloaded. And you'll notice, since I did it manually with a Save As, it is not in the Downloads folder. It's in this faux USB, my external USB drive that I downloaded the file to. And finally, of course, you can click on a garbage can, which will delete the file. And for the record, these files that have lines through them are files that you downloaded previously, but have since been removed. The files are no longer where Edge downloaded them. So that's the bottom line. If I were going to make a single suggestion, I would just have you remember Ctrl-J so that you can see not only where the files have been placed, but see what all files you've been downloading and where they went. Different browsers can at times make this slightly confusing because they all might use different terminology and have things in different places. But once you get the hang of how your primary browser deals with all this, the rules actually end up being relatively simple. But like I said, when all else fails, Ctrl-J. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2775. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.